The game of futsal quickly moves through phases, from defense to attack and vice versa. If you throw in the fact that teams look to exploit any kind of attacking situations, then you can see why identifying your defensive game plan is crucial. Today, we are going to look into the types of marking futsal, whether it's individual, zonal, or something else. So first of all, if you're brand new to our channel and you have not seen any of our videos before, thank you very much for checking out this one. We are a channel dedicated to futsal and to spread valuable information about the beautiful game to all of our subscribers and to you guys. If that sounds like something you're into, please consider subscribing to the channel so you don't miss out any future uploads and help us grow the futsal community. Let's dive in. The purpose of the defensive marking futsal is to prevent an opponent from making successful offensive plays without committing many fouls. The rules of futsal punish excessive fouls or more than 5 fouls per half with a direct kick, so the defensive marking must be efficient without being overly aggressive. The defensive system in futsal consists of the types of marking, or in other words, how to mark, and the defensive lines of marking, or where to mark. Within the how to mark, a futsal team can defend with either individual marking or man-to-man, by zone or mixed. On the defensive lines of marking, depending on where you're from and your beliefs, it can be divided into 3, 4, or 5 lines, but this is a topic for another video, where we'll discuss only the lines of marking. In this video, we'll just focus on the types of marking. In the man-to-man or individual marking, the player is marked, not the ball. The defender usually marks a specific player throughout the court, anywhere the player might go. The system can be divided into pressure and half-pressure marking. Pressure marking requires the scorer to engage in direct combat with the opponent in any sector of the court, seeking to prevent the opponent from receiving the ball. And half pressure means that the pressure on the offensive half is only on the player who receives or is in possession of the ball, without the need to pressure the other players who don't have the ball. By imposing a man-to-man marking, the defensive team makes long-distance shooting difficult, decreases passing options, forces opponents' mistakes, generates a greater physical wear and tear on opponents due to the need for constant move to get out of marking, decreases the opponent's possession and reaction time to think about which move to make. On the other side, this type of marking also has its disadvantages. As it does on the opposing team, it also promotes a great physical wear on defenders trying to follow the movement of attackers. It leaves the middle of the court open because of the distance between the players, facilitating infiltrations and what we call balls in the back. And also, the opposing team may have a numerical advantage if one of the defensive players get dribbled. The second type of marking, the zone defense, consists of assigning each player of the team a defined zone of defense, with the task of occupying and defending that specific area. In this system, the ball is marked, not the player. The combat is applied on the opposing player more directly when the players enter the defender zone, without, however, the defender being obligated to follow the player outside of the zone. The zone marking is very advantageous because it facilitates coverage and recovery in case of dribbling. There's less physical wear and tear on defenders, provides good possibilities for counterattacks, and decreases balls on the back and the space in the middle of the court. The negative points of marking by zone are that it enables long distance shooting, it increases the time of possession of the opposing team, and it can partially block a goalkeeper's vision. The last type of marking, the mixed marking, uses zone marking combined with individual marking. Basically, it comes down to marking an opponent individually at the same time that the other players are marked by zone. There are two ways this system can be applied. A team can be positioned on zone marking, but a player can follow its opponent switching positions with a teammate and covering their zones. However, it requires a lot of communication and chemistry between players in order to make it work. The other option, which is very unlikely to happen, is one that a specific defender will strictly follow a single player anywhere on the court regardless of anything, while the other teammates will remain defending by zone. This is more common in young matches, youth matches, where there might be a player who alone can make a difference in the game result. So a coach will try to prevent that from happening by putting possibly the best defender to follow that player throughout the court. That's it, guys. This is all you should know about the types of marking in futsal. If this video was helpful, hit the like button below. Consider subscribing for more futsal related videos and hit the notification bell. And I'll talk to you later.